There's a basket for Smaragda in the warehouse. She's waiting.
What does it mean to be truly righteous? To never succumb to temptation, or to take a vow of chastity despite constant temptation. Our heroine did not know the answer to this question and preferred never to dwell on it. If it were up to her, she would have chosen the quiet life of a nun. However, destiny had something different in store for her.
I'm sorry. Maybe I can help.
You're the last person I need right now. Get lost.
Sorry.
For the sake of the prayers of all the... Stesha, do you have something prepared for Smaragda? It's cold today, isn't it? Oh, potatoes! Thank you. Thank you.
The sisters loved Indika. Christian love is known to be patient, merciful, and faithful. However, in a lowly human sense, they didn't love her that much. To be completely honest, they didn't love her at all. Many of them felt nothing but disgust for her. Indika, however, was not to blame. Were it not for the voice that was inculcating ideas in her, unforgivable for a Christian, she would have been a virtuous and rather mediocre nun. Indica's biggest dream was for that voice to leave her alone once and for all. Her entire life became a struggle, a painful resistance. No matter how hard she tried, no matter how much she tortured herself, The voice grew louder and more convincing every day.
Sisters, today I was walking, Lord forgive me, through the refectory, and I saw the servant of God holding the life of Passion Bearer Hermin of Athos. So I went up to her, quickly made the sign of the cross, and added, God grant you patience, Mother. For I worship Mount Athos, my sisters. The spirit of the Holy Church lives on, only on Mount Athos, where they fast according to the canon.
Bring some water.
Useless labor is the basis of spiritual development. Obedience is above fasting or prayers. Indika didn't understand why she needed to retrieve the water from the well if there was a pump next door that took it from a sacred spring. She didn't understand why drinking from the spring was allowed, but cooking soup was a sin. The well was only about 15 meters away from the spring. It was not possible to have any other water there. Even a tenth of it is the same. They say on Epiphany, even a drop of holy water blesses an entire canister. If that were true, a couple of evaporated drops from the spring would bless the puddles beneath them.
We haven't eaten even 10 of them. With God's help, we'll make it to spring. No way. Sisters won't eat after her.
Mother, the sign of the cross saves from the plague, but this...
Glory to... Smaragda, don't tempt me. I'm sending Evdokia to you. Don't let this one into the refectory.
Accept me on this day as communicant of thy secret supper, for I shall not divulge thy mysteries to thy friends. shall give thee no kiss akin to Judas, but as an outlaw shall I confess thee. Remember me, O Lord, in thy kingdom. May my communion of thy immaculate mysteries, O Lord, not be judged or condemned, but heal the body and soul. Servant of God, Seraphim, I shall know. Servant of God Indika shall now take communion with the body and blood of our Lord and God and Savior Jesus Christ.
It is forbidden to leave the convent without a blessing. Despite her requests, Indika had not been blessed to leave for a full year. When she was tasked with delivering the letter, it took her completely by surprise. Even though she did not know the contents of that letter, she could not shake the feeling that it would play an extremely important, perhaps critical, role in her life.
How would I know what's in it? What is in it? What's in it?
What's in it? What's in it? What's in it? What's in it?
For the sake of the prayers of all the saints, Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us. Tisha, I need to go to the other side. Georgie, pirate, be quiet.
The animals feel the unholiness.
They're just happy to see me. Tisha, I'm sorry.
The animals feel the unholiness.
I brought you some apples. Orlovka, your favorite. Tisha, I must hurry to the train. Tisha, what have you done?
boots are all wet. He'll slip and fall again. Don't worry, Tihon. I understand. Forgive me, for Christ's sake. Tihon has the key. Oh, what an imbecile.
Indika loved Tihon. Imbecile was a medical diagnosis, so she was just using the word literally. In any case, Tihon couldn't hear her. Hypocrisy isn't really a virtue, is it? It was as if the convent didn't want to let her go. Even though she knew there was no place closer to God, she yearned to leave it, at least for a short time.
Not true!
I think deep inside she hated her monastic cell, Smaragda's tasteless cabbage soup, the smell of rotting old women that even...
Now I have come unto thee, my lord and goddess.
She couldn't even read. Even if the abbess was literate, she surely didn't go out of her way to use that skill, just like her personal...
I have recklessly forgotten thy glory, O Father, and among sinners I have scattered the riches which thou gavest me. For as thou in thy deep wisdom hast had compassion on us, so also in these latter days hast thou made us anew by thy bloodshedding. Like the man who fell...
Sister Martha's tooth.
O ineffable and unseen grace, for who can tell of thy mighty works, O Christ, or who can number the multitude of thy wonders? And now I cry to thee.
Your name of God, signing the cross over her mouth after every yawn, before entering the temple, after crying, after leaving the temple, after entering the refectory.
As a disciple of the Lord, O just one, thou hast received the gospel as a martyr. Thou art never turned away as the brother of God. Thou hast boldness as a hierarch. Thou canst intercede. Do thou intercede with Christ God that he may save our souls. Because of thy boundless mercy and compassion, I dare to approach thee, O Christ. Receive me as thou didst the publican, the prodigal, and the harlot. As of old, thou didst raise up the paralytic, O Lord God. By thy godlike care and might, raise up my soul, which is palsied by diverse sins and transgressions, and by unseen meat deeds and acts, that saved I may cry out. Glory to thy power, O compassion of Christ.
But even incense could not cover. Half of the sisters couldn't even read. Even if the abbess was literate, she surely didn't.
The soul is wasted with evil in this battle.
Just like her personal hygiene, always at lunch, she would carefully clean the devil's work from her dentures.
Like the man who fell among thieves and was wounded, so have I also fallen.
As they were repeated so much, they lost their original meaning. Hated to smile at Sister Martha's toothless jokes. Hated the fuming candles, the rotting potatoes, the never-ending advice, lectures, the humility, the fear of God, signing the cross over her mouth after...